Captain, the ship's remains correspond to the freighter we've been searching for.
We have to look for survivors and confirm the shipment was in fact stolen.
Preparing to board.
After salvaging? Oh, okay. You enter what's left of the freighter as the bay doors close behind you. Within it, you find the remains of what used to be an enormous commercial freighter. Well, I was going to say fighter, but no, freighter. You can see all sorts of supplies and objects on the floor, accompanied by what were once their crew. Ah. After some time searching the corridors, you come to a passageway with two possible paths. Oh, wow, okay. Zorg, is it? Back from when I was a kid? Can't even remember. All right, let's go to the right. You see a hammer. Pick up the hammer. No, your crew, and you advance through the corridor you've chosen. The further in the ship you go, the more you get the feeling that you are not alone. After a while, you reach another crossway. Okay, go right. After walking in circles, you arrive at a hallway and a bay door that opens in front of you. Through the door frame and still within the darkness, you are able to make out a faint light. Well, we're soldiers. No matter if we don't like the feeling of it, let's enter. As soon as you enter, the bay doors close and the lights turn on. At the end of the room, you see the raw protonite shipment stacked in rows that emit light rays of light. Light rays of light. A robotic voice surprises you. It seems to be the ship's MI system. Intruders detected in the loading bay, activating security protocol, opening evacuation bay doors. Wow, okay. Halt, we are the crew of the Genesis of the Republic. The AI waits a few seconds and begins to speak again. Opening suspended. Validated credentials. Error. They are intruders. No, I am Captain Scott. We are here to rescue the freighter. The AI system hesitates for a few seconds. Establishing analysis. Probability of intruders not being identified as intruders. 100%. Okay. You hear the servo motors of the evacuation bay doors screech. What? If you open the bay doors, the shipment will be lost. Establishing analysis. Probability of intruders not being identified as intruders. 100%. Okay, so... The probability that intruders won't identify themselves as intruders. Okay, I guess we need to... If you open the bay doors, the shipment will be lost. Negative, the shipment has been anchored here to ensure its security. You can see the chests have mechanical anchors latched to the floor, although some are completely damaged. Okay, then we are intruders. 0% probability that the intruders are identified as intruders. Establishing analysis. Error. The AI begins to calculate probabilities. While it seems confused... Only someone who isn't an intruder would claim they are. What are your orders, Mai? Alright, let's try and confuse it. Only someone who isn't an intruder would claim they are. If the intruder claims it is an intruder, probability protocol, incompatible. As it exclaims different errors, you hear the voice shut down due to a logic error. The bay doors close, you are now out of danger. Brilliant. Brilliant. Okay, mission accomplished. Load up these crates onto our ship. Maybe there's more to it than that. I guess not. You load the chest of protonite on the ship and you look for a registry of what could have happened. The engineers search through the few working terminals left, but all data appears to be corrupt. You make a security copy to be able to study it later. Winnings, raw protonite.
Let's go back to the station. Ooh. To inform Susan.
What kind of pirates assault a protonite freighter just to abandon it?
X-Player's weapons do not correspond to the radiation we've been following.
Captain, the coded data seems to follow the same pattern obtained in the slaver space. Our team can't undertake an investigation. We haven't found enough matches.
Okay. Not sure I really understand that. I'll have to go back through it again in a minute. I'm so attached to getting all the salvage. Now that I know you can save it for future playthroughs as well, that is really cool. Maybe I shouldn't just be opening everything I get. But hey. All right, back to the station. I'm impressed with the fight. This small ship, this hunk of junk, as I think someone called it, seems to handle itself pretty well. Is there any way of seeing a log of... I'm just gonna press some hotkeys and see what happens. Ooh, not that one. No. Continue. Right, don't know what I pressed. Is it just in the inventory, maybe? Nope. Map, no. Alright, I want to see a log of the chat. And see what the guy said.
Hey,
Okay, let's leave the fast travel on and see if it does bring you to a stop. It does.
Comms G. That's good. Request permission to dock.
Station control tower here. Dock at the assigned bay. Over.
Receiving coordinates. Establishing communication. Docking protocol prepared.
Awesome. Let's see if I can do this a bit quicker now. So there should be a green light showing me where I need to dock. There we go. That'll do, right? Yeah. All right, that's a lot easier than I thought it was earlier. After arriving at the station, you go to the docking port where your ship is located. In it, you spot Susan, who rushes out to meet you. You've returned. Have you found anything? Susan looks at you expectantly, waiting for an answer. All right, okay, so I've got to deliver some bad news. We'll probably be nice about it. Yeah, we found the freighter. There weren't any survivors. Susan looks shocked by the news. After a few seconds, she recovers and begins to speak. That can't be. I knew the pilot ever since we were kids. Were you able to recover the cargo? That's the first thing you ask after figuring out a childhood friend has just died. Yes, we were. Well, at least there's some good news. Our crew is currently heavily invested in the repair work. Since you need the ship as soon as possible, maybe your engineers could help us. Could you process the protonite slabs and fabricate a new ion reactor? Of course. Show me how. You've obtained the first blueprint with it and the specified materials. You can create the blueprints object in your task plan. Okay, so where's... That's a blueprint. No, that's not a blueprint. Ooh, I've got a rare salvage pod. Now, at what point do I start thinking about saving these? Not right now. I'm going to just open them now. But that's an interesting idea. Weapons and some objects can be scrapped. In order to do that, go to the task panel and assign the required task, insert the object. Okay, so tasks panel. Okay, there's no task right now. And the crew member who will be undertaking the task. Go to the department screen. In the inventory and salvage the raw prototype. Okay. Can anybody do that? I've got to salvage it. Okay. Ooh. Right, it's the ion reactor I want to do, but now I know I can build all these too. Ion reactor build. Can I assign two crew members to make it go quicker? There you go. Wow, that was super quick. Got it. Susan examines the ion reactor closely. An excellent job. With this, we'll have everything we need to finish the repairs. I have another favor to ask you in the meantime, while we finish things up. Speak with me when you're ready to go. Okay. Oh, so I just lose the ion reactor I just built, but that's fine. Shall we open these? Yeah, let's open them. I'm assuming I'll get more time to save stuff. How do I do something with this? Requires processing before using. So... That's not there. Scrapping. That? Ooh, nice. Okay, so I get 5,000 out of it. Is that the right place to do it? Not the sick bay. Not the research lab. Okay, let's try that then. How do I take them out of here? Oh, just like that. Easy. And it'd be nice to know if having two in there really does make it quicker. Like, they have a skill, but how does that apply? That'd be nice to know. All right, complete. Loads of stuff. Wow. Okay, that's awesome. Accept the contract to the inspection. We've stopped receiving protonite shipments. After the attack on the freighter, we can't guarantee the commercial route security to the mining stations in the sector. Inspector Howard Huggins must fill out his forms immediately. Transport him and evaluate the station's status. All right? I think I can accept that. Now what? Just go do it, I guess.
Well, we have a long way to go. We should depart. Engines on maximum drive.
Oh, okay.
Unauthorized order. You lack bridge privileges.
Yeah, you tell him, Mai. Put your foot down.
So now I have a babysitter? Is the Republic sending you to watch over me?
It's a matter of security, Mr. Huggins. The last protonite shipment was assaulted.
Captains are not what they used to be. If a pirate ship attacked me, there wouldn't be enough space for them to hide.
We're sure of that.
Well, that guy's fun to have around. I still haven't run into an asteroid. I kind of want to.
Hell? These transport ships are not ours.
It seems they found a more interesting intermediary than your company, Mr. Huggins.
This can't be. We have to register this immediately.
How do we register? Okay, let's stop moving. At any moment in the game, you can access photo. Great. Photo mode. Selfie mode. In it, time will halt and you will have complete control over the camera and its parameters in order to take spectacular pictures. Save them directly to your computer or press the button to hide the interface and take a screen cap with Steam's own system. Press P to enter photo mode, okay, and then press the left mouse button to immobilize the camera. Adjust photography values to your liking and take a picture. Alright. Like that? Ooh, okay. Well, that's awful. I'm not a photographer of any kind. Oh wow, you can zoom in quite well. Why is it so blurry? Oh, there you go. Yeah, that's better. Take a picture. All right. Wait, how do I stop this now? Back. Pressing P doesn't stop it. Just continue.
When the foreman finds out, heads will roll.
All right, escort to the second mining station. Let's see if I can go around this in super fast time mode.
Captain, we have to go back to the station now.
What happened?
I forgot my lunch.
Mr. Huggins.
False alarm. I found it.
Nice.
Captain, there's no sign of activity on the station.
It looks completely abandoned. We should dock and discover what's going on here.
I'll stay on the ship. Covering your backs.
Good idea. That is for the best, actually. Alright, let's get down here pretty quick. Wait, it looks damaged. Looks like it's been abandoned for a long time. I can fire at it, just so you know. I just thought I'd try it. Oh, it says stop on there. That's good. I hadn't even seen that. I like it though. Alright, the dock bay doors open and the captain and his crew arrive to a great reception hall. It currently only has emergency lights on that show the remains of broken furniture strewn around the floor, forming large amounts of rubble. Okay. We need to reactivate the generators, look for survivors, or let's continue our advance. I think looking for survivors is something I want to do. Let's do that. From within the darkness, the crew discovers buried bodies among the remains of the station. Well, that's not looking good. Upon digging one up, they discover that he is still alive. They came. We resisted. The moan moves his arm. The man. The moan. Oh dear. The man moves his arm slowly and pulls out his ID card. He offers it to you and finally dies. Great. Okay. I don't think it'll be useful at all. We should leave the station. Grab the ID card and let's go. You advance through one of the hallways, guided only by the emergency lights. On the walls, you can see scratch marks and blood illuminated softly. Ooh. After a while advancing, you reach a completely sealed bay door. Next to it, you can see a small key card reader. It's currently inoperational. So can I use my card? We need to reactivate the energy flow in order to advance. Maybe we could open a breach by firing at it? No. We could use a small explosive to open our way. Let's reactivate the energy flow. You search the chamber for an energy terminal to re-establish the systems. After a few minutes, you find a room that contains generators. The head of the engineering team comes near you. Captain, we've detected an anomaly in the generators. We could use the remains of one of the destroyed machines to make them work again. Okay. Go ahead, try. Maybe it's best we leave the station. I mean, the head of engineering would know more than me, right? So I don't want to fix it myself. Yeah, go ahead, try. Your engineer's capacity to craft isn't high enough to guarantee your success. The engineers look over the damage to the generators and they quickly begin to argue over the cause of the blackout. When they arrive at a consensus, they collect different objects that are later placed randomly in the damaged area. Amongst the different tests the engineers make, one of the objects short circuits and electrocutes one of the engineers. Brilliant. Without being able to re-establish electricity, we won't be able to advance. Let's head back. Okay, so that's quite cool. This reminds me very much of FTL. Those sort of parts of it, anyway. Pretty cool.
We've looked over the station. There are no survivors.
But this can't be happening.
We have to inspect the last station.
I think I've had enough. We should head back.
Oh, if you've
had enough. This oversteps your jurisdiction, Mr. Huggins. You can come with us or stay here. You decide.
This is an outrage. You guys are kidnapping me.
Preparing the jettison hatch for immediate exit.
Nice.
All right, fine. I'll go with you.
Thank you, Mai. Right, so that's the one we were at earlier, right? I don't want to be stopping here. Why did we stop? I didn't press that. There's an attack going on here. I think I just saw that guy launch a missile. You finally arrive to the last station after hearing Inspector Huggins' complaints the entire time. You can't wait to finish the mission. Everything looks calm on the station when suddenly a group of ships appear in the area. They are pirate ships. You recognize X-Plio's emblem on their hulls. Maybe they want revenge. There's no time to lose. You order your crew to prepare to defend the station. Everyone to your posts.
Captain,
let's do it.
The station is under attack.
I told you we should have gone back. We can still turn the ship around.
Control yourself,
oh, wait
Mr.
a second.
Huggins. We won't abandon any innocents. Crew, stay alert. We'll
right.
hold off the enemy attack.
Sir, yes, sir.
The green and red. They're very important. I think I just fired a nuclear missile at that guy. Luckily, it doesn't seem to lock onto allies. But it does just randomly explode. So, luckily, I didn't kill him.
Wow.
The only red guys are bad. Who would have thought? So I'm still not quite sure about when you're firing at long range, should you be leading the target a little bit? I mean, I assume so. Trying not to get right into the middle here, but might as well now. Fired a nuclear missile. Wonder if it does AoE damage. Come on, get him. Nice. Did it do some extra damage to the guys nearby? Maybe. The shields were quite damaged. Ooh, sorry. Ramming him now. Getting in really close seems good for my ship. Not so good for theirs. Everything else done, right? After the skirmish, the mining station's director thanks you. Thanks, Captain. Those pirates appeared out of nowhere. They wanted to keep our pyronite extraction. We're lucky you arrived when you did. Well, you're safe now. Oh, are these attacks normal? The director responds in a nervous tone. No, this area is usually very peaceful, but the past few days there have been a few skirmishes between pirates and trade ships, but this exceeds any other incident we've had to date. All right, do you have any information that could be deemed useful? You ask the director if he has any relevant information that could shed some light on the pirates' intentions. He responds, I have no idea what they could want besides our protonite, although an attack of this scale, it just isn't logical. Oh, wait a moment. The director disappears from the visor, only to return a short time later. I've been informed that we've recovered an encrypted transmission on one of the ships. Maybe it'll help you. Cool.
Captain, Chief. The corrupt transmission corresponds to the rest of the data patterns.
Is it possible to begin an investigation, Crewman Burton?
The science team currently believes we have enough data to decode everything. We will begin right away.
Cool.
Understood.
Can't believe I fired a nuclear missile at an hour. Don't I feel silly? Actually, there's one here, isn't there? Come on. I like this salvaging mechanic. I think it's really good. And I think the fact that it gives you sort of a crate, I think they got into a little bit of a hoo-ha about whether to call them loot crates or not, actually. But I really like that it gives you a salvage crate, and it's such a good mechanic. I think that's what makes it a roguelike, that you can then pass that on to a future game, to a future playthrough. I really like that. It does mean that it ties you into salvaging everything. I feel like if you miss anything, then it's too big a loss. Or chance of a loss, I guess. Maybe I'll feel a bit different after doing it for a few hours. There you go. Right, that's everything done. Let's head back to the station. I guess we can start researching there. Doesn't actually say, but I assume so. Cool. Very smooth. Very smooth playstyle, considering it is early access still. I know we're not a million miles away from release, but still pretty impressive, I'd say. I like it.
Control Tower, we request permission to dock.
Station Control Tower here. Dock at the assigned bay. Over.
Receiving coordinates. Establishing communication. Docking protocol prepared.
I wonder if there's an easier way to get to the docking. Or if that'll be added on release. This is possibly a little bit tedious, or would become tedious eventually. Well, actually, after the first one, they haven't really taken that long. That's cool. So, I mean, that seems a much easier thing now. Oh, no, he says while drifting backwards. There you go. So it turns green when you're within it. It was blue to start with. It turns green once you're in. That's pretty good. Doesn't take too long at all. Okay. I've got some research to do. And different people to do it. Cool. That started the research. Why did it disappear?
Republic ship requesting docking permission, please.
Station Control Tower here. Dock at the assigned bay. Over.
Receiving coordinates. Establishing communication. Docking protocol prepared.
Okay, that's a bit strange. That might be a bug. I'll I am going to obviously report some bugs. This is early access, so I feel like I'm helping test a few things here. That I feel like a bug. I feel is a bug. It wasn't just a repeat. Once back at the station, Howard says his goodbyes with few words and he leaves the group. Well, good. Susan comes up to you with more cheerful demeanour. You're finally back. Inspector Huggins looked a bit out of place. Did everything go well? Is there any place in the sector that isn't ridden with death? No, it's best not to ask. Wow, sorry to hear that. Susan looks away for a few seconds, but recomposes herself and resumes the chat rapidly. In any case, we have good news. It was tough, but your ship's repairs have been completed. I guess this is goodbye? Don't be strangers and come visit us if you're ever back in this sector. Of course, we'll see each other again. I hope we never come back here. Alright, so...
Captain, our scanners detect multiple signals in the area. Maybe we should investigate them before warping to Tacit Stella. Perhaps someone needs our help.
Okay, that's good. Give you some reason to stick around, I guess, for a little bit. So what has this just given me? That was weird. Are these all the pieces of equipment off that last ship? Yeah. Right? Except this one, obviously, which I got before. All right, well, let's open a few more. I don't know why it's giving me the equipment off the ship. Surely they need that. Plasma Cannon Mark 1, that's the same as... Oh, no, that's the light Plasma Cannon Mark 1. So better range, way better hull damage and shield damage and accuracy. Let's equip it. Why not? Nuclear missile we've already got. Light Cannon of the Republic, 1400, 30, 10, 26. 1400, 5, 30, 33. Okay, so overall, damage is a little bit less, accuracy a little bit more, but you need a good mixture of the two for the split in hull and shield damage. I like that. Reminds me of EVE Online a little bit.